Hello everyone, my name is EquilibriumEST and this is my Dragon Age Origins gameplay series, episode number 35. And currently we are looking for the sacred ashes of Andraste. I think I should check the corridors that I left behind. There are no corridors left behind, damn it. Weird. Should I go left or should I go right?
Stop! You will go no further!
Oh, is that so?
You have defiled our temple. You have spilled the blood of the faithful and slaughtered our young. No more. You will tell me now, intruder, why you have done all this. Why have you come here?
Tell me your name and I will tell you why I'm here.
I am Father Colgrim, leader and guide to the disciples of Andraste. Kill us, and you will face Andraste. She will smell our blood, and the blood of her children on you, and her wrath will be great.
Andraste is dead.
The prophet Andraste has overcome death itself, and has returned to her faithful in a form more radiant than you can imagine. Not even the Tevinter Imperium could hope to slay her now. What hope do you have?
I wish to see this arisen Andraste.
None but the disciples may approach Andraste. She is not ready yet. But when the time is right, she will descend upon the nations in fiery splendor, and all will know her. But perhaps there is a way to make up for your recent transgressions.
I'm not doing anything for you.
If you will not repent, then you will die.
Is there a reason it refuses? There is power to be gained and it refuses? For what?
I don't trust Colgrim's offer.
Consider what it has to gain. These little humans as allies. Power that it sorely lacks. All in exchange for placating their mad little god.
You don't really think it's wise, do you?
Maybe not. But it certainly wasn't boring.
To arms, my brethren! Andraste will grant us victory!
You thought I had
God damn it. I should drop something.
Of course.
Okay, so I have a feeling I should go back and check the other route, which went from the big room. Because it seems that this will lead me forward. Okay, so let's check where this road leads. Okay, now this room is done. Okay, let's level up Liliana and win. Okay, let's finish the archer and let's take ranger afterwards. Ooh, arcane warrior. Okay, that might be fun. Okay. Not sure which one to take. Maybe this one. Ooh, yeah, that's definitely that one. Because if I understand correctly, Wind can now use heavy armor. That is pretty badass. Yeah, looking good, looking good. I wonder if my quick save is not working and why. Weird. Okay, now it works cool.
My only consolation is that if that thing swallows me, I will give it indigestion.
Yes. And now the quick save doesn't work again. I don't understand.
As you say.
I'm here for the Urn of Sacred Ashes.
You have come to honor Andraste, and you shall, if you prove yourself worthy.
But what if I'm not?
Then you will not come to the Ashes. It is not my place to decide your worthiness. The Gauntlet does that. If you are found worthy, you will see the urn and be allowed to take a small pinch of the ashes for yourself. If not...
Okay, let's do it.
Before you go, there is something I must ask. I see that the path that led you here was not easy. There is suffering in your past. Your suffering. And the suffering of others. You abandoned your father and mother, leaving them in the hands of Rendon Howe, knowing he would show no mercy. Do you think you failed your parents?
Yes, I should have defended them to the death.
Thank you. That is all I wish to know.
Accept your failings, but do not let them govern your life.
You could not have known what would happen. You did what you thought was best.
It seems that reflection on past mistakes is a constant preoccupation of the religious mind.
And what of those that follow you?
Ask your question, Guardian. I am ready.
You are ever the advisor. Ready with a word of wisdom. Do you wonder if you spout only platitudes, burned into your mind in the distant past? Perhaps you are only a tool, used to spread the word of the circle and the chantry. Does doubt ever chip away at your truths?
You frame the statement in the form of a question, yet you already know our answers. There is no sense in hiding, is there? Yes, I do doubt at times. Only the fool is completely certain of himself.
And you? Why do you say the Maker speaks to you, when all know that the Maker has left? He spoke only to Andraste. Do you believe yourself her equal?
I never said that.
In Orlais, you were someone. In Lothering, you feared you would lose yourself, become a drab sister, and disappear. When your brothers and sisters of the cloister criticized you for what you professed, you were hurt, but you also reveled in it. It made you special. You enjoyed the attention, even if it was negative.
You're saying that I made it up for the attention? I did not. I know what I believe.
Shale, the stone giant. There is so little I can draw from you. I feel the distant echo of a soul, dormant for so long, now awake.
Good for you.
And with the awakening, the slow realization of all you have lost. Ah, Shale. Your entire existence is a test of your will and courage. You have my respect. The way is open. Good luck, and may you find what you seek.
Okay, that was, well, informative. Right, I think I have to rearrange my... or have to check my save game stuff. I'll be right back. Okay, that's better.
The smallest lark could carry it, while a strong man might not. Of what do I speak?
A tune.
Yes, I was Andraste's dearest friend in childhood, and sing. She celebrated the beauty of life, and all who heard her would be filled with joy. They say the Maker himself was moved by Andraste's song, and then she sang no more of simple things.
Echoes from a shadow realm, whispers of things yet to come. Thought's strange sister dwells in night, is swept away by dawning light. Of what do I speak?
Dreams?
A dream came upon me as my daughter slumbered.
It seems so, yes.
It told of her life, and of her betrayal and death. I am sorrow and regret. I am a mother weeping bitter tears for a daughter she could not save.
I'd neither a guest nor a trespasser be. In this place I belong, that belongs also to me. Of what do I speak? I'd neither a guest nor a trespasser be. In this place I belong, that belongs also to me.
Home?
Of what do I speak? It was my dream for the people to have a home of their own, where we would have no masters.
Yes, it was.
The enemy of my enemy is my friend, and thus we followed Andraste against the Imperium. But she was betrayed, and so were we.
An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. The debt of blood must be paid in full. Of what do I speak?
Vengeance?
Yes, my husband Hisarion would have chosen a quick death for Andraste. I made him swear that she would die publicly with her war leaders, that all would know the Imperium's strength. I am justice. I am vengeance. Blood can only be repaid in blood.
Okay.
A poison of the soul, passion's cruel counterpart. From love she grows, till love lies slain. Of what
jealousy?
Speak?
Jealousy.
Yes, jealousy drove me to betrayal. I was the greatest general of the Alamari, but beside her, I was nothing. Hundreds fell before her on bended knee. They loved her, as did the Maker. I loved her too. But what man can compare with a god?
The bones of the world stretched towards the sky's embrace, veiled in white. Like a bride greeting her groom. Of what do I speak?
The mountains, I think.
Yes. I carried Andraste's ashes out of Tevinter into the mountains to the east, where she could gaze ever into her Maker's sky. No more fitting a tomb than this could we find.
Okay.
No man has seen it, but all men know it. Lighter than air, sharper than any sword. Comes from nothing, but will fell the strongest armies. Of what do I speak?
Hunger?
Yes, hunger was the weapon used against the wicked men of the Tevinter Imperium. The Maker kindled the sun's flame, scorching the land. Their crops failed, and their armies could not march. Then he opened the heavens and bade the waters flow, and washed away their filth. I am Kefir, disciple of Andraste and commander of her armies. I saw these things done and knew the Maker smiled on us.
I
she wields the broken sword and separates true kings from tyrants. Of what do I speak?
Mercy?
Yes, I could not bear the sight of Andraste's suffering, and Mercy bade me end her life. I am the penitent sinner who shows compassion as he hopes compassion will be shown to him.
Okay.
My dearest child.
I wish it were not so, but I know you are dead.
You know that I am gone, and all your prayers and wishes will not bring me back. No more must you grieve, my boy. Take the pain and the guilt, acknowledge it, and let go. It is time. You have such a long road ahead of you, and you must be prepared. And so I leave this in your hands. I know you will do great things with it.
Okay.
We will need to fight you.
Fighting myself, more or less. That sure was weird.
This chasm.
Here I am.
También.
Of course.
So I can't move with anyone?
Whatever.
Well, that's messed up. Okay, and it's time to end episode number 35 right now. So, in the next episode, we will try to solve this puzzle. But until then, have a great evening. I will see you in the next episode. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow me on Twitter, and see you soon. Bye bye.